Andrew, Governor Todd Whitman, you guys are billing yourselves as the Forward Party. That is the name. Not left, not right, Forward. So what does that mean? Andrew, I'll start with you. What is your elevator pitch to Californians who are going to watch this conversation? What do you want them to know?
If you're watching this right now, the odds are very high that you feel shut out of your own state's government. You don't feel like your leaders are listening to you, in part because California is a one-party state, and most people now are on the outside looking in. That's what we have to change. We are teaming up with the Common Sense Party here in California to give people a genuine alternative that, just like the name says, is for common sense solutions and not something that's an ideological back and forth.
All right, so Governor Todd Whitman, I want to kind of hone in on that because there's the partnership with the Common Sense Party here in California. And just to give folks a little bit of background, you guys are partnering with them, kind of a subgroup of the Forward Party. They're trying to become a legitimate political party here in California. According to the state constitution, they need 73,000 registered voters by October. I believe that there are just over 33,000. So what's your take on this possibly being confusing to voters? Why not just have the Forward Party be a party here in California?
Well, the Common Sense Party is working on the same principles that the Forward Party has. It's about giving people choice. It's about making every vote count, even if you live in a heavily Democrat district and you're a Republican. You didn't bother to vote most of the time because you felt it didn't make any difference. What we want to do is open that process and change it and break the hold of the two parties. And Common Sense was well on their way to doing it. As you said, they have some 33,000 votes, signatures already. So we want to help them get all the way across the finish line with the 73,000, actually more than that, so that when they start throwing out vote names, because the two parties hate what we're doing. The two parties do not like it because they understand that it's a real challenge to them. It forces candidates to talk to everybody. It forces them to want to be liked by everybody because you want to be number two on everybody's ballot if you're in a ranked choice voting. And here in California, you do have a choice of two when you get to the end of the election process. So we want to see that and encourage. We want to see that broadened, widened. And that's what Common Sense was already working toward. So it's a natural amalgamation, as it were, a partnership. And once they get registered as a party, we'll see what happens with names and things.
All right, so you mentioned the two-party system. They both don't like what you're doing. Andrew, you mentioned it too in one of your answers, that this state is under one-party rule. We have a Democratic governor. We have supermajorities in the legislature. So to do something like this, you are going to have to go up against a brick wall that is a strong Democratic Party here in the state of California, and also unions. Unions are a force here in the state of California. And even Democrats who might go up against a union bill in the legislature, they could potentially know the consequences of that will be getting a union-backed challenger. How do you combat that?
You, in many ways, framed the challenge perfectly, Mickey, that it's not left or right here in California. What it is, it's insider, outsider. And the vast majority of Californians now feel themselves to be on the outside looking in, whether it's a company or other special interest that has the ear of legislators that don't actually have to deliver any meaningful solutions to stay in power because it's a non-competitive system. Now, a majority of Californians see that, look, even if you're a Democrat, you might not be excited about what's happening or not happening in your community, whether it's your school or public safety. I'm here in San Francisco. Homelessness is obviously a problem. And your representatives don't have to change anything. That's what we are going to change together with the majority of Californians who want common sense solutions. Go to cacommonsense.org and join the new party. All we need is another 40,000 registrants, and then we'll be on the ballot from 2024 onward.
So you mentioned special interests. Does that mean Forward and Common Sense are not pro-union?
We're not taking that kind of position. We are about people. It's up to the people. We want to put power back in the hands of the people. Most of these elections here in the state of California, certainly the local elections, congressional, are over once the primaries are over. I mean, that's it. The districts are set up so that across the country, there are 500,000 elective offices. Fully 70% of those are uncontested. That's just wrong. Everybody should have a choice. That's what we want to see, is give everybody the opportunity to have a choice in these elections, in this election process, and get candidates who are responding to what the public wants, what the voter wants, what their issues are, not what some amalgamous body out in Washington tells them they should be concentrated on or concerned about. It's what are people here concerned about? Homelessness is clearly going to be an issue for the people of San Francisco and Los Angeles, and it's not unique to California, but certainly there's going to be major issues here that are not going to be the same in other parts of the country. And so we want to create and see created by people, by the grassroots, the kind of party that responds to them. And that's why we're concentrating on the local offices, because, you know, your mayor, your county commissioner, your head of the school board or the library commission, they're important offices and they need to have people who are responsive to their constituents in those positions.
It's the phrase, all politics is local. Andrew, I know you and other members of this party are going around the country and talking to folks in other states. What's the response been so far?
The response has been tremendous. We have almost 500 people coming to this event today in San Francisco, and the same number of people signed up in Los Angeles. And that's true when I go to the South, the Midwest. Most Americans are fed up. You know, if you ask people how things are going, 75-80% will say that they could stand a dramatic improvement. And they also know that they're shut out from their own leadership, their own representatives. 75% of the country is like California, where one party is in charge. So you get presented what should be a two-party system. For most of us, you don't have two meaningful choices. And that's unfortunately the way the special interests and the folks on the inside like it. So that's what Forward is changing, and people are here for it, whether it's in California or any other part of the country.
Governor Todd Whitman, I want to ask you about some comments you made in July of last year during an interview with PBS that I saw. And you were asked about the Republican Party, and it was right after the Dobbs decision, and you were a pro-choice Republican. And you were asked about your optimism of the Republican Party. And I want to read part of what you said and get you to react to it. So you said, well, since I'm a firm believer that our country does better with two parties, a center left and center right, I believe we have to have that party back. You go on to say, so I think we're going to see some changes in the future, but I do believe we need we do better with two parties. You've obviously pivoted when it comes to that in a way, because you guys are talking about this third party option. What was was there a breaking point for you where you said, okay, we need to have another option here?
Well, I've been trying to do what I could to get the Republican Party to stop this slide to the far right, to the extreme. There's nothing wrong with being conservative, but the extremes that are now, you know, promoting these conspiracy theories and the election deniers still, I was trying to get it back from that, and it became patently obvious that that was not going to happen. And so I'd been a part of another organization that was focused on the Republican Party doing that. And it just came to the point where we all decided, along with Andrew's Forward Party, the Renew America movement, the Save America movement, those were the Republican sides of it, said, we'll do much better together, and the heck with it. We have to understand that we have to give people a choice, and that's going to require right now another alternative for people. We can't do it through the two parties. They are too entrenched in the way they control politics and the way they control the issues. It's just what our founding fathers worried about. They didn't like parties because they were afraid that parties were going to trump policy. And that's what's happened. It's party positions now that have become more important than solving these problems. And in fact, you will get elected representatives who will admit to you, and certainly I've seen it, I know Andrew's seen it in the course of our careers, where people don't want to solve the problems. They want to keep them going because it helps them energize their base. And that's just wrong. Our elected officials should be about representing us and solving our problems, not ones that they think, not creating this divide and making it so you have to hate one another if you have a different opinion on an issue. You may have a different opinion. You've got to respect the fact that that person does. Try to find out why they believe that, if you believe the opposite, and see if you can't come to some consensus in the center there so you can move things forward, because that's what we should be about, forward.
All right. We will leave it there. Former Governor Christine Todd Whitman and Andrew Yang, former candidate for mayor in New York City and also a former presidential candidate. We appreciate your time here on Inside California Politics.
Good to be with you.
Good to see you, Mickey. Light the beam.